Now I am going to discuss the sample problem 219. In this problem, it is said that determine the wrench resultant of the three forces acting on the bracket. So this is a given bracket, and we are asked to find the wrench resultant that we have just discussed in the previous video, right? So it says that calculate the coordinates of a point P in the XY plane through which the resultant force of the wrench acts, right? So here a point P is given, it's an arbitrary point, and it is asked that find the coordinates of this point P through which the wrench will pass, right? And also find the magnitude of the couple M of the wrench, and also it is said that find the magnitude of the couple M of the wrench, right? So first, we will assume that the wrench resultant is positive, right? So this is very important. First, we will assume that the wrench resultant is positive. At the end, from the result, we will conclude that whether the wrench is positive or wrench is negative. But from initially, we will assume that the wrench is positive, right? So first, what I will do, I will find the resultant of these three forces that are the given forces, right? So if I find the resultant, so the resultant will be equal to the summation of all forces, and the Rx component of the resultant will be equal to summation of all forces along x, right? So if I write, so then this will be equal to, so here only this 20 Newton force is along x, so we can write directly that this is 20i, and it is in the positive x direction, right? So this is the Rx component of the resultant. Then Ry will be equal to the summation of all forces along y. So then we have only this 40 Newton force along this y axis, right? So we will write 40j, and this is again positive. Similarly, the Rz component will be equal to, so this is the Rz component, right? Only in the z direction, this force is acting only in the z direction, that is positive z. So I will write plus 40k. So if we write the resultant, so then the resultant vector will be 20i plus 40j and plus 40k, right? So this is the resultant vector, and we need to find out the coordinates of that point P for this resultant, right? So if we draw that resultant at this point P, so this will be that resultant. And initially, we will assume that the wrench is positive, right? So let's suppose if I draw the resultant at this point P. So let's suppose that this is our resultant at this point P at some angle, right? And this resultant has three components, right? So one component is in the positive X, right? So this is the positive X. One component is in the positive y, so I can write like this. This will be parallel to the y axis, and one component is in the z axis, right? So one component is here along the z axis, right? And initially, we will assume that our wrench resultant is positive, right? This means that the resultant and the couple both have the same direction. So let's suppose if I represent it. So if I draw the wrench, so the wrench will also be, the couple will also be in this same direction. So let me put it here, right? And if we define the direction, so then this will be the direction of that couple, right? So if we curl our right hand fingers in this direction, so this will be the couple direction. And since the couple and the resultant are in the same direction, so we have assumed that this wrench resultant is positive, right? Let's say that this couple is represented by M. Let's suppose that this is M couple, right? Let's say that this is Rx, right? Since this is the component of the Rx component of the resultant, right? And let's say that this is Ry and this is Rz, right? So if we find the moments of these Rx, Ry and Rz forces, and then we find the total moment, so that will be the couple at this point P, right? So first I will find the moment at P due to Rx, right? So this will be equal to, and if I want to find the vector, so then this will be R cross Rx, right? So then we, for this Rx, we will define our moment arm. So let's suppose that this is our moment arm for this Rx, Right, so it will be from this point to this point. Right? So for this we need to find the coordinates of this point. So what is the coordinates of this point? Let's suppose that this P is the origin, this point P is the origin. So then the Rx will be equal to, so then we need to travel minus x to reach this point, right? The point of application of this Rx, right? So this will be minus x I, right? And then in the y direction we need to travel minus y, right? So this will be minus y I. And then since this point is in the xy plane, so there is no need to travel in the z direction, right? So the, let's suppose that this point of application is, let's suppose t, right? So the coordinates of t are what? So the coordinates of t are minus x, minus y and 0, right? So to find, to write this r vector, right? So we will subtract the coordinates of origin from this. So we can directly represent this r vector in terms of these coordinates, right? So this is minus x I minus y I y j, right? So I will write y j and then cross r x. So this is r x, right? So we will write 20 I. So now if we take the cross product of this, so we will be able to find the moment at P due to r x. So if I draw this figure again, so if I multiply this, so then this will be plus minus minus 20x and I cross I is 0, right? So this will become 0 and then we will write plus minus minus 20y and j cross I is minus k, so minus k, so this will become positive. Right, so this is the moment at point P due to the Rx component of the resultant, right? Then we will write that moment at P due to Ry, right? So this will be R cross Ry. So now we will define the moment arm for the Ry, right? So if I define the moment arm, so then this will be the moment arm for this Ry. And then we will find the coordinates of this point. This one, let's suppose that this point is Q, right? So we, if we want to find the coordinates of point Q, so if this is the origin, so we will travel, this distance is x, right? So we will travel minus x, right? So in the x direction, we will travel minus x, then we will travel minus y, and along z, we need to travel this 60 mm distance, right? The height of this bracket is 60 mm, so I will write 60, right? So these are the coordinates of point Q. So then we can write this r vector in terms of these coordinates. So this will be minus x I minus y j and plus 60 k. So this is the moment arm vector for this ry, and we will take the cross product with this plus 40 j, right? So this will be 40 j. So this will be the moment at point P due to Ry. So if we take the cross product, so then this one will be plus minus minus 40 and I cross J. I cross J is K, right? So this will be minus 40X and this will be K. And then J cross J will become 0. So then we will write plus 40 into 60. And K cross J is minus I, right? So I will write I and this will become minus, right? So this is the moment D to Ry. And if I simplify this, so then this will be minus 40X K and this will be 2400 I. Now to find the moment at point P due to Rz, so again we will define the moment arm for Rz. So this is the Rz. So if I define the moment arm for this one, so this will be the moment arm for this Rz if I draw. So then this is the moment arm. And what will be the coordinates of this point? Let's suppose that this point is point S. So what will be the coordinates of this point S? So to reach this point S from this origin, right, so we need to travel this much distance along x from here to here, this distance, right? So we can represent this distance in terms of this 100 mm, right? So this will be 100 minus x. This distance is 100 minus x. This point P is arbitrary point, and we need to find the coordinates of this point P. So this distance will be 100 minus x, right? So I will write the coordinates of S is 100 minus x. So this is the x coordinate, and then in the y we will write this 80 minus y, right? So I will write 80 minus y, and since this point is in the xy plane, so the z coordinate is 0, right? So we can represent this moment arm in terms of these coordinates, right? So I will write 100 minus x I plus 80 minus y j, and this is the moment arm, and I will take the cross product with rz. So this is that 40 newton, and this is 40 k, right? So I will write 40 k. So if we take the cross product of this, so then this will be, and let me draw that here again. So I, j and k. So this will be 40 into 100 minus x, and I cross k. So again it is minus j, so I will write minus j. And then if I multiply this, so this will be 40 into 80 minus y, and j cross k. So j cross k is I, right? So if I write this in order, so then this will be 40 into 80 minus y I, and this will be minus 40 into 100 minus x j, right? So now we know the moments of all the individual forces that are given, right? So if we want to find the total moment at point P, so the total moment or couple at point P will be equal to the resultant of these three moments, right? This moment, and this moment, right? So we will add the corresponding components, right? So this is minus 2400, and this is 40 into 80 minus yi, right? So we will add up this, so this will be equal to minus 2400 plus 40 into 80 minus y, and this will be the I component of that moment, right? So this is the resultant component along x of that moment, right? Then we will add up the j's component, right? So then there is only this component, right? So we will write minus 40 into 100 minus x, and this will be multiplied by j, and then we will add up this and this. These are the k's component, right? So I will write plus 20y minus 40x into k. If I simplify this, so then this will be equal to minus 2400 plus, this will become 40 into 80 will become 3200, and minus 40y into I, this will become 4000 minus 40x j, and this will be minus 40x plus 20y into k, right? So if I simplify this, so then this will be 800 minus 40y into I. This one will be minus 40x plus 4000 j, and this one will be minus 40x plus 20y into k. So this is the couple vector at that point P. So now to find these x, y and z, what we will do, since we have assumed that the couple and the resultant are both in the same direction, right? We have assumed here that the couple, this couple vector and this resultant vector, they are in the same direction. We have assumed that this wrench is positive, right? So this means that the corresponding angles of this R and this M will be equal, right? So if you want to find the angle of this resultant with the x, y and z axis is right, so we can find that. So how to find that? So we know the direction cosines. So we know that our x will be equal to r cos of theta x, right? We know this. So then cos of theta x will be equal to rx divided by r, right? So this is the direction cosine we know, right? So this will give us the angle of the resultant with the x-axis, right? So this will be that angle with the positive x-axis, right? So the direction cosines of this moment and this r will equal, right? Will be equal if they are in the same direction, right? So if we find this, so then this will be rx is how much? So rx is 20, right? This is 20 divided by r. So we can find the magnitude of this r, right? So what will be the magnitude of this r? So r magnitude will be equal to 20 square plus 40 square plus 40 square under the root 2, right? So we can find this magnitude. So let me find this. So this resultant comes out to be 60 Newton, right? So now we can find cos of theta x. So this will be 20 divided by 60. So then this will be 1 by 3. So this is the direction cosine, right? Similarly, we can find cos of theta y. Then that r y will be equal to, I can write it like this. To find r y is equal to r cos of theta y. So then cos of theta y, the direction cosine along y will be equal to r y divided by r. So then r y is 40. We know the magnitude of r y is 40 and this is 60, right? So then this will be 2 by 3 cos of theta y, right? And similarly, we can find the cos of theta z as well, right? So I can write that cos of theta z will be equal to r z divided by r, and r z is again 40 and this is 60, so we will get that same 2 by 3. So now we know these direction cosines for this resultant, right? And we know that we have assumed that this couple is in the same direction of r, so then the direction cosine of both will be equal, right? So now this means that if we find the direction cosine of this m, so what will be, this is the components, right? So the direction cosine, if you want to find cos of theta x for this m, right, so then this will be mx divided by the m magnitude, right? So then this is mx, we can write. So then this will be 800 minus 40y divided by the m magnitude, which is unknown, right? But we know this cos of theta x, right? So this cos of theta x, this cosine of this moment, this direction cosine of this moment and the direction cosine of the resultant will be equal, right? So this cos of theta x of this moment is equal to the cos of theta x of the resultant, which is equal to 1 by 3, right? So we can write it like this. So this will be equal to 800 minus 40y, and if we multiply this, so then this we can write it like this. So this will be m divided by 3. So we can write that this is equation number 1, right? Then we can compare the cos theta y of both r and m, right? So I can write cos of theta y. So in case of m, this will be equal to m y divided by m magnitude, right? And this is m y. So we can write it like this. So it will be minus 4000 plus 40x, right? So I can write it like this. Or I can write that 40x minus 4000 divided by m magnitude. And this is equal to the direction cosine cos of theta y of the resultant, right? So this is cos of theta, which is 2 divided by 3. So this is 2 divided by 3. So we can write it like this. So it will be 40x minus 4000, and this will be 2m divided by 3. So this is equation number 2. Similarly, we can write cos of theta z. So cos of theta z for moment will be equal to mz divided by m, and mz is this thing, right? So this is minus 40x plus 20y divided by m magnitude, and this is again 2 divided by 3, right? This 2 divided by 3. So then we can write minus 40x plus 20y, and this will be equal to 2m divided by 3, and this is equation number 3. Now we will solve these three equations simultaneously. So then these are three equations and there are three unknowns, right? And all these are required. We want to find this x, y and the magnitude of this m. So from this equation, the m divided by 3 is equal to this thing, right? So if I write equation number 2, so then this is equation 2, 40x minus 4000, it is equal to 2 into m divided by 3, right? This m divided by 3. So m divided by 3 is equal to this. So I can write this equation number 2 like this. So this will be 2 into 800 minus 40y. This is the replacement of m divided by 3. So this is equal, m divided by 3 is equal to this. So we can simplify this. So then this will be equal to 40x minus 4000 and 2 into 800 will be 1600 minus 80y. So if I simplify this, so then this will be 40x and if this comes to this side, so then this will be plus 80y and this will be 1600 plus 4000. So if I simplify this, so then this is 40x plus 80y and this is equal to 5600, right? So we have combined this equation number 1 and 2, right? Similarly, if I write equation number 3, so then this is 40x plus 20y and this is again 2m divided by 3. So again, we can replace m divided by 3 by this. So then this will be 800 minus 40y. So again, if I simplify this, so then this will be minus 40x plus 20y, this will be 1600 and this will be minus 80y, right? So I can write it like this, 40x plus 20y, and if this 80y comes here, so then this will become 100y, right? So I will write 100y is equal to 1600, right? So let's suppose that this is equation number 4 and this is equation number 5. Right, so if I write equation, this equation here, so this will be minus 40x plus 100y is equal to 1600. And if we take the summation of this equation 4 and 5, so this will cancel out, this will become 180y and this will be equal to 7200. Right, so then we can find the y coordinates of that point P, so 180y, so y will be equal to 7200 divided by 180, right? So if I solve this, so y comes out to be 40 mm. Point P is 40 mm from this point, right? Let's suppose if we say that this is that 40 from this edge, if this was the origin, right? So then this is point P, right? So then this length is from this x-axis, is this y coordinate is 40, and if this is the origin, so then this is 40 from this origin, right? If we say that this was our origin, right? So then this is 40 mm. The x, if we want to find the x coordinate, right? So then we can use any equation, right? We can use this equation number 5, right? Let's suppose if I use this equation, so then this will be minus 40x and this will be equal to 1600 minus 100y. So then this is minus 40x, now we know y, right? So this is minus 100 into 40. So this will be 1600 and this will be 4000, right? And this is minus 40x. So if we solve this for x, so we will get x coordinate of that point P. So this comes out to be 60 mm, right? So this is the x coordinate of that point P. And now we can find this m magnitude, right? So if we use this equation, right? So then if I use this equation, so then this is 800 minus 40 and y is 40, right? And this is m divided by 3. So if we solve this, so we will get the moment, the magnitude of that moment. So the m magnitude comes out to be minus 2400 newton mm, right? So as we can see that the magnitude is negative, so this means that m, that couple that we have assumed initially in the direction of r is in the opposite direction, right? So from this we conclude that the wrench is negative, right? So initially we have assumed that wrench is positive But now, from this magnitude, we conclude that trench is negative, right?